technical issues.
Yep, so hopefully this will be good.
Yep.
All of my guys are gone.
That's not good.
Where'd they all go? Oh, like, they took off.
Oh, because the AI took over for a turn. It moved them away.
Oh no.
They're still in your borders, but...
Most of them, some of them are in the water.
Yeah. OBS briefly showed a warning high CPU encoding message something. The high encoding CPU usage. But the window's too small to actually show me the entire message.
That's not good. We'll just have to keep an eye on it.
Yep. It's not dropping any frames or anything. Okay. Next turn.
Yes. Go there. No, you. Why? Oh my gosh. Why are you in here? I want you there. I want you there. No. It's like still doing all the turns of everyone else.
Hmm.
Okay, you stay there. You come back up on land. You come back up on land. You come back over here. Alright. Don't care about that. Gamer quest. Oh yeah, definitely doing that. Get rid of them. For some reason, I'm in plus three now. I feel like I probably lost something last turn.
Plus three what?
Plus three gold. No, where are you guys going?
Where is Geneva? They want to trade route. Okay, they're right there.
Now we're starting to go where we need to go. Hang tight. You here. You here. Fortify until healed.
Bringing his army back into position.
Yeah, because it was removed from me. Okay, I don't know. We can't trade resources amongst each other, right?
Not that I know of.
Like, I couldn't give you gold for whatever.
Nope.
Oh, wait, I think we can. Your items, when...
I could just send you gold and stuff.
Oh, you don't have to do that. I'm getting plus three per turn now. I was just more curious of if we could.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm good.
Alright.
There we go. Prague searches for science.
So discover the most technologies. Small wants the hanging gardens built, which I can, in theory, do. Well, you just came out of nowhere, Mr. Hand Axe Man.
Yes, build a mine there because I need the gold desperately. Okay. I think I'm good. I can't really do much right now.
Yeah.
I probably need... Okay, I'm making a workshop here. Coliseum's going to increase happiness, but it's going to cost maintenance. Happiness is going to be really important. No one's built Stonehenge yet?
Nope, but, you know, as soon as you start, someone's going to complete it.
Yeah, but it only takes me 9 turns to complete. Yeah.
Also, I started on the Parthenon. Just FYI.
Okay. Market is gold. Wonders. Eight turns, but that bumps me down. 16. 18 plus 5. Let's do that. I'm gonna try and get Stonehenge. I doubt I'll be able to.
Well, did you put that city on production focus?
Yeah, it only bumped it up to 1 turn.
Yeah. That tends to happen with wonders.
Great Wall has been built. That would have been nice to have for me.
Yeah. Looks like... Japan? No, Rome did it. Okay.
Oh, that means all those cities get walls, don't they?
Yep.
Alright. If I can start getting some ships out, I can start really doing damage, but in order to do that, I need the info panel. Where's our tech stuff? My tech tree is gone. Research info, there it is. 2 turns we get physics, crossbowmen, ironworks. Pikemen. Armory, longswordmen. What do we get to... What do we need to get better ships? Oh, we need theology to get the compass.
Apparently. That's what we need.
So I'm gonna go. Alright, so we'll go theology next, I guess.
Do I give the Zulus back a settler, or do I take it for myself?
I'm gonna have war on all fronts.
Oh, so... No, it's just a worker, so... I'll give them back the worker. Nope, it's a settler for them. Should have taken it as a worker.
How do you gain more points towards a golden age?
Excess happiness per turn fills it up.
Theology. You've discovered physics. Thank you. So physics is on the agenda.
Of course he did.
Oh,
2 away.
That's not good. I don't even want to know how many turns away I am from... 5 turns away from Stonehenge. I think it just gives me some faith. Ooh, I got a great prophet.
Found that religion.
Yeah. Where do I want to go next? I don't build anything on the Machu Picchu or whatever it is, right? The Great Wonder.
What do you mean?
There's nothing to be built there. Like to get the stuff from it, it just
get it. It needs to be within your territory.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I guess build a farm over here. Okay, great profit. Found a religion. What would be a good symbol for my religion? Shoshone? I don't know enough about religious symbols to know what all these are.
I think if you hover over them, it says what they usually are.
Tengrism,
Zoroastrianism.
Wow, that's impressive. I'm gonna go with Tengrism, I think. I like the symbol. It's kind of cool. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna change the name. And it's gonna be the Burnout Prophecies. The Burnout Chronicles. Oh, you can't spell it. It's too hot. It's too long.
Yep.
Burnoutism. Sounds like high school back in the day. Messenger of the Gods. Plus two science. Okay, got that. Founder belief. Select a founder belief. Global happiness for every two cities following this religion. Plus two gold for each city. Ooh, I do need the gold. Gain science when a missionary or prophet spreads this religion to cities or other religions. Plus one global happiness for every eight followers in the... I think I'm gonna go with plus two gold, because I've been real short on gold. Shrines provide plus one happiness for cities with three followers.
I don't want to, but I may have to fight the Zulu just because they're being a big old jerk face.
That's not good.
I gave them back their settler, and they're still not friendly with me.
I think I'm gonna go with shrines give happiness, because everyone has shrines. Are you sure you want to found burnoutism? Or, hold on, let me see here. I'm gonna change it. It's gonna be... I'm gonna change the name here. Come on.
Oops, Saber joined the game. Hi, Saber. He joined chat.
Hey, what's up, Saber? You pickism. Huh? What?
Oh,
my camera froze.
Let's see, we're playing on Prince, so normal difficulty. Continents, small, quick. Robert and I are on a team against all the AIs.
Huh? No, it's not battery. Yeah, this is the same thing that happened before. My camera software doesn't like Civ.
Anything other than quick speed just makes the game unbearably long.
Yep. Great person. Yeah, I did that. And I founded Upickism. So, for some reason, my camera does not want to agree with me right now. So, I can try it one more time to run as administrator. But I keep getting an error code that says something about rendering it. And now I'm black screened again. This thing. All right, hold on. Let me shut everything down and then come back up, because for some reason it does not want to listen.
Okay.
You can keep streaming, but I gotta close all the way out, because I don't know what's going on.
I imagine camping with flies in the cold would not be fun, Saber. But it's good that the LARPing was fun.
Creating direct 3D device. Error code. Please make sure DirectX 9 is installed. So it looks like SparkoCam and Civ are both accessing DirectX, and it's causing a problem.
I don't know why it would.
So I'm gonna take a look and see if I can SparkoSoft. I mean, I can send in an support, but Yeah, and then I'm gonna restart and try and come back in, or I can just try without the camera for now. Might be easier.
But game sounds are a bit loud. Audio, sound effects, down.
Yeah, so the error code that I got said, please make sure DirectX 9 is installed to continue.
You would think it'd be installed.
Well, I think it is installed. So I'm back on cam, yes?
Yep, you're showing up on Skype.
And then I'm assuming it's something to do with Civ, because we've had more issues with Civ than any other game.
I mean, Civ is always temperamental with multiplayer.
Try it one more time, and if it just doesn't work, I'm just going to continue without camera.
Yep, that's fine.
So hopefully it freezes on a really cool picture of my face. All right. All right, loading up.
Yep.
Okay, eventually I will be able to get in there and maybe not die. Things are starting to turn around. I got gold coming in. My religion's helping me with happiness and gold now. We got trebuchets, so I'll be able to defend my cities a little bit better. Let's see. Can you send me a invite?
Yep.
All right. All right. Coming back in. Eventually.
My webcam following my face may be a bit too zoomed in at times.
Yeah. Gives everyone a really, really close up. All right. Pocatello joining the game. A new challenger has arrived. So how's everyone enjoying their Sunday? Saber apparently had a lot of fun at... Man, my guys are like running into other people's territory. AI, what are you doing to me?
That could be problematic, that Rome is now the ally of Mogadishu.
I don't understand how my guys get so far in one turn when it takes me like 8 turns. Also, my archers are in boats on land. So there's that.
What?
You see my archers?
You've got your spearmen in boats next to the archers.
I don't know what's going on. but I'm just gonna assume it's not good. Hopefully everyone comes back. Where's my other spearmen? These guys. Can we just please get back over there? Oh, yeah, well, I just started a golden age, so that's good. Alright. I guess Saber's asking if you can lower overall volume a bit.
Yeah, I tried. Let's see if I can do... Okay, that should be better, hopefully.
Yeah, let us know.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
No, what are you doing? Okay, you're fine.
Oh no, someone plundered a trade route. Oh, barbarians.
Yeah, I had that happen earlier.
I thought... Oh no, you didn't, Zulu!
Oh man. Just hang out, guys. Just chill. That's all we need to do is chill. My guys are literally in boats in the city. It's pretty humorous.
They're showing up fine as archers for me.
Nah, it's probably just a graphical glitch.
Yep.
Oh, someone else spread religion over here. Who was that? Is that Rome's religion?
Possibly.
I think it is.
Okay, so I now have enough faith that I have a chance at getting a great profit, so that should be fun.
Yeah, I want to start spreading mine around, I think.
Zulu is bringing their warriors out to play.
I always really enjoy when we have people that are in chat that know way more about, oh, you got Hanging Gardens? Cool.
Yep.
Yeah, when people in chat know way more about the game that we're playing than we do,
mm-hmm.
Because essentially, yeah, I am nowhere near an expert on this.
Yep.
This has a plantation on it. I recommend you construct a lumber mill. Alright, let's do a lumber mill. Choose production. Since I got Stonehenge, monument cost us. Increases the culture. I don't really care about the culture. That brings more production. You know what I'm gonna do? I wanna finish the workshop here because that's important, and then I'm gonna start pumping out some trebuchets to get my cities covered.
Oh, suddenly everything. So can't construct Stonehenge. I got the Hanging Gardens for someone. They want Notre Dame. They're impressed with my culture. I can't get Stonehenge for them. They want cotton, and they're happy that I got the Hanging Gardens.
Yeah. I have a feeling is my camera still up? I just got like a weird screen flash.
Yeah, it seems like it's still there.
Plunder trade route. I don't want to do that. I don't know whose trade route that is. The city of Adika once dies. Connecting that resource to your trade network will cause the city to enter We Love the King Day. Interesting.
Okay, I'm friends with Mogadishu.
I should probably work on more trade routes, but I'm really concerned with Rome right now.
Yep, now focus on Rome. I also should be doing trade route stuff, but Zulu is asking for it.
Theology will be in 2, and then we can, or at least I can start going for Compass, which will give me more ocean control.
I may have just gotten booted. It went to a loading screen.
Yeah, I got a loading screen too. Interesting. Says I'm back.
Yeah. No idea what happened there.
Not sure. Don't worry, every time I do that, my spearmen are in boats again. next turn. I've discovered civil service. Really? Where?
I got civil service.
Oh, okay. Alright, theology will pop in one turn.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm gonna go for compass. Alright. I want to pause the stream, but every time I, like, leave the game is when it starts to freeze up, so I don't want to mess with it.
Yep.
I'll just let my computer run a little hotter than I normally would.
Yeah, I guess. My camera is set to follow my face, so that's why it adjusts the zooming.
Finished theology. Where's my production? What did I get here? Okay. Choose production. Granary. It will bring each source of wheat, bananas, and deer. Oh, I do have some deer here. Bring extra food. A shrine. It's probably really good. But I want to get a workshop. And research is definitely going to be the compass. What's here? Interesting. Interesting. I don't like Rome. Rome bothers me. I'm really worried that I have Rome and Japan over here, and I'm trying to go for a combat victory. Because Japan's, like, brutal to fight against.
Yep. Just wait until the modern era and bombard them with airships.
Yeah. Alright, you guys hang out there for a bit. Ooh, trebuchet. Yes. Barrage or open? They seem to be on the plains, so I'm gonna go with open terrain. And then I'm gonna send them up here. Choosing production. Oh, that's... Are you going for the heroic epic?
I think that's a national one, so every civ can do it. You can just only do one of it.
All newly trained non-air units in the city receive morale promotion. Oh, I'm going to do that. And then what else do I want to do? Show queue, add to queue, oracle. Which one are you going for right now?
I'm not working on any wonders right now because I'm building up an army for Zulu.
gonna go for sure. Let's go for that. And then this guy here. Oh, he's already doing his thing. What do you need? Lighthouse. Each source of fish. Temple forge. Each source of iron brings production. Yeah, and then what else? I need a workshop. Should probably get walls at some point.
Walls are nice to have.
Yeah. It's gonna get real bad. I'm just curious if I'm gonna get everything in place or if Rome's gonna attack first.
I got a great merchant and a great prophet in the same turn.
That's pretty good.
Yep.
I just like scroll through all the city state stuff because in my mind it's just like, yeah, you're just there until I need to conquer you later.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really pay too much attention. Saber's gonna have to give us both a schooling on exactly what we're doing wrong, mm-hmm. and how to improve.
Found a religion.
Yep. What time is Champs doing Firewatch?
She said 5, which should be 4 your time and 6 my time.
What time is it now? 2:16? Okay. I don't want to like step on her toes or anything. Mm-hmm. Also, I really want to watch her yell at Henry for a while. Only in a golden age for one more turn. How did I lose iron?
Did you build a unit that has it?
Maybe trebuchets? Maybe?
No. Maybe a city-state you were friends or allies with stopped giving it to you?
No, I have an iron mine that has 6 in one of my cities, and it says at the top that I have 1 iron and 1 used, so I don't know what's going on with that. Unless they're not citizen management.
Alright.
Oh, it put it back on default focus for whatever reason. Which is why I'm getting, like, no gold right now. That's what happens when you drop out of the game.
Yeah. Alright. Which icon do I want? The Dutch were Protestants.
So do you have to be working a tile in order to, there we go, in order to gain the stuff from it?
Maybe. Do I want +1 gold for every 4 followers or +1 culture, or no, I want the tithe.
I already stole Upickism.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out a name. I asked chat, no one has suggested anything yet. Okay,
we could call it, Quintinism. call it Ryanopolis. So he's a part of our game.
Yep.
You're from Chicago, you could call it deep dishism.
Yep. Let's go with cathedrals, because those can hold a great work of art slot, and once I crush Zulu, I will be switching to culture. Alright, no one has suggested a name. Let's see. Okay. Deep dishism.
Are you going with deep dishism?
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay. They want Machu Picchu. They want culture. They're friends with me. They're allies with me. Great person. I got whales, probably from a city-state. Another great person. And I found a deep dishism.
That's a good turn.
Yep.
Oh, they desire a trade route. I should probably be doing that.
Where is Antetokounmpo? Because they want a road to my capital. That's gonna take a while.
You guys have built your lumber mill there. Let's come back here and get some deer. Because it seems important. Uh-oh, now I'm losing gold like crazy. Because I'm out of my golden age.
Yep, that'll happen.
You have accumulated enough faith to purchase a unit or building, buy one in a city following the appropriate religion. Okay. So I can purchase a missionary, and the missionary does what? That spreads my religion?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Let's do that. And then I want him to go down here and spread my religion. Let's see here.
Alright, now that I have religion stuff, let's build a temple and start getting more faith.
Sydney's under attack.
Yep. But
I don't even know where they are.
They're a little up by me. They've got a barbarian encampment just to the north of them.
Hmm. Compass, 14 turns to compass.
I get better trade routes with the Zulu, but I'm about to crush them.
Huh.
Well, not crush them, so...
Are you gonna go to war with them, or...?
Yeah, because they're annoying me.
See? It all comes down to war, eventually.
Yep.
War.
War never changes. Let's go buy. Well, hold on. Which do I want? Well, let's start working on Notre Dame quickly. Go buy a barracks in Utrecht so that I can get the heroic epic in my capital where I'm pumping out the units. Yep, you missed it, Saber. I called it deep dishism.
Sir Mukan Verulia. Alright, yep. I have no clue. I don't think either one of them said anything when we logged in.
I'm in a golden age. Huzzah.
What's the range on a trebuchet?
I think only two tiles, but...
Oh yeah, it's a little bit... It's a little bit far for that. Interesting. What's up? I'm not doing anything, Rome. I'm just putting my people here... in case. We just didn't have any other space for him. anywhere else in my giant...
Okay, now I see your spearmen is boats on land.
Okay. See, they're just chilling, like in canoes. Just yep. Sitting there. I don't know why Rome is getting so nervous over here. Oh, they have a trebuchet. Oh no, that's their ballista, not yep. Trebuchet.
Is that fancy?
Yeah.
Oh, how nice the Zulu have a trade route with me. That's going to end poorly.
Spread religion. Eupicism. That's right. 5 followers of Eupicism. It's like a virus. Okay, gold maintenance, the forge is coming along, then the workshop, then the walls. What do we got going on up here? In one turn, I'll get the heroic epic, and I'll be working on that. And I'll be working on that. Oh, wait. I'll go back there and see.
I'm gonna run to the restroom. I'll be back.
Okay. Let's see here. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get my butt kicked. I really want to get my ships out and doing some damage before I go to war if I can. Can he just keep spreading religion? Interesting. Well, I've already spread it there. I might as well bring it up here to spread again. I didn't know that you could spread it to... I thought that once you use the missionary, it was done. You use it one time and it's gone. But, apparently I was incorrect. That's pretty cool. I did not know that they were. Yeah, I just brought them down here and I spread the religion to my other city because it was infected by Rome and their religion. So I brought it down here and spread it, and I guess you get to keep it. And I did not know that.
Yeah, that's...
Did you know how many times you get to use it for? Is it only once or twice? Or at least twice now, I guess, since I've already used it once.
I believe you get 3 uses of them, but I don't remember. You got a shrine. You get a shrine. You get a shrine.
Are written on the units.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that seems a little convenient. Spread religion uses 1. Well, thanks. okay, cool. So I have 1 use left, apparently. I'm going to spread it to my other city up here because I need the gold.
Ooh. I can buy land schnecks. That's gonna help against the Zulu.
You can buy what?
Land schnecks. They're mercenaries.
Oh. Never heard of that.
It's for one of the policy tracks.
I haven't adopted a policy in so long. I have no culture.
I'm at 25 a turn.
I'm at 15 a turn. I'm at 258 out of 285, it says. I don't know if that's, like, rolls over every time.
No, so, like, I'm now down at 19 out of 495.
Ooh, Caravan, what do you need to do? Establish a trade route. Okay, trade route with this caravan in my own cities doesn't really do me much good. Oh, I could trade with Japan, get a lot of gold. They would be getting +3 science per turn, but they'd also be getting pressure for my religion. I do really need the gold. So I'm gonna do that. Let's see here. Liz Hartsu, hey, how's it going? How are you doing?
Hello.
Thanks for stopping by. I don't think I recognize that name. So if you're new, thanks for stopping in. If you're not new, I'm sorry, I'm very unobservant.
Mm-hmm.
So. Aw. I was working on that.
Yeah, that's...
And that.
That's how things tend to go.
I was working on both of those. That's fine. I think I had just started. Oh, I can adopt a policy. Why did you... Oh, you... You sneaky sneaks.
What did they do?
They expanded their territory where I was and kicked the person off of it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So Liz Hartsu is new. So thank you for stopping by. We really appreciate you coming out and watching us play some Civ. This is more or less just to kind of wind down the Sunday. We have lots of different stuff. I'm not sure how you heard about us. You could let us know. We'd really appreciate hearing how you guys hear about us, because mm-hmm. that would be awesome. So I have honor right now. I've topped that out. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if I'm going for a combat victory, what's better? Because I have my religion going, so piety maybe, or maybe commerce?
So commerce, the first one on the right is what lets you buy Landschnecks, but you will need a decent amount of gold for that. But I mean, look at what you get for adopting all the things, and that can help guide your decision. But until we get to like the ideologies, I don't think any of them really directly help with combat, although exploration might help with naval stuff.
Well, the honor tree's done now. Mm-hmm. The commerce helps you with the inevitable gold deficiency, so I think that's a good point, Saber, because mm-hmm. the first thing is commerce boosts capital gold output by 25%.
Yep.
So I think I'm going to grab that and just go with it. Not really into the Landschnecks, but the wagon trains is pretty nice, too.
Mm-hmm. And Liz Hartsu, you played Civ, but wasn't good at it, so they watch people play. That's fine. Yeah, we're not awful, but I mean, I know people who challenge themselves to get good enough to play against deity AIs. So, we're not nearly that level, but we're not terrible. But we are on a team to help some against the AIs.
Yeah, basically, right now I am. We're on a team, the two human players are on a team, mm-hmm. and every other AI is on its own team, and I still feel like I'm struggling, so we're definitely not the ones to look at for expert play. We're just more or less kind of killing a Sunday afternoon and hanging out.
Yep.
And talking to people in chat. So high level AI cheats, I don't like playing against that.
I mean, they get advantages to help them out, so.
Oh, do they really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I'm not about that life.
Yeah, like, we're playing on Prince, which is normal difficulty, so I think that puts them on an even playing field with us. And then, as you get better, or harder and harder, they get more and more advantages.
So right now, I'm kind of feeling the gold cost. I feel like I'm up against that wall, and building the army up that I want to build up is probably going to be a bit much. So I'm assuming that I probably need to start, like, beefing up my trade routes and getting more and more caravans. And I think that maybe that's where I'm, like, falling behind at. So if you have any thoughts or ideas on that, please let me know. Alright, returning that. Barbarian encampment, don't really care. I'm sure some of that's important, but... I used to play COD a little bit back in the day, but we're talking like before Black Ops. And after a while, like, I used to play Halo a lot too, and then after a while I just kind of stopped. Lately, I mean, actually most of what this channel does right now at least is D&D. We've got quite a few games going on, different campaigns and stuff like that, and then in between we kind of just sit down, we get multiplayer games and play them together, like Civ, Armello, and then some of our other members are also doing games like Firewatch, which will be on later, and I think you were talking about doing Undertale or something?
Yeah, so what I'm going to do is send out a Twitch, I should probably adjust my webcam zooming thing, but... what I'm going to do is send out a Twitter poll, give some suggestions on games I want to play, and see which ones you guys would be interested in watching, and that'll determine what I play next. Right.
I guess... conversion of production to research... I guess I'm going to go for education. I don't know. And then, you got Notre Dame.
Yep.
And I've discovered the compass. Your webcam zooming gimmick is distracting, to be honest.
Yep, I will adjust that momentarily.
Okay, so for the sea trade routes, I just got the compass, and I can build the harbor, which is what's required to build sea trade routes, right? Or am I incorrect in that?
No, you need to get a cargo ship to do a sea trade route.
Oh, alright. Well, I'll get one of those. I only have one city that's on the coastline, though, so... I think I can build a harbor, because the harbor does something. What does the harbor do? I probably can't even see it this turn. I probably have to wait till next turn to see it.
Yeah, I'm not sure. And let's see. I think I need to briefly take my webcam down in order to adjust it. So I'll be backstream. You should still be able to hear me, but you won't see my face for a little bit.
All right. I think this is going to be more important than that for now. So I'm going to try and get the cargo ship up and going. And then I'm going to try and get... I have the workshop in here. You all right? Okay. I'm going to try and get the workshop finished over here because I have really bad production on this city because it's pretty much a bit smaller than the other one.
Yep.
I mean, I could try and bump production up, but it... drops my gold down by one, and it only brings the production up by one, so I guess I could do that and help out a little bit.
Okay, that should be better. It won't be following me around all over the place anymore.
Yeah, COD 4 was good. I played, I think I played Black Ops, the very first Black Ops, a little bit with my buddies, and then I played Modern Warfare, was it two or three? I think it was, well, both, but I think mostly it was three. But after that, I'm not competitive enough to play the multiplayer games and care about them. So when I start playing them, it usually ends up with me just like trying to have fun and then getting yelled at for having fun, and that's just not what I'm about, so I don't really care too much. I'm done.
All right. Okay, so yes, Harbor does help see trade routes, but they don't. You don't need
they're
one.
Not, okay, they're not a requirement.
Mm-hmm. They used to be, but that was before the Brave New World expansion changed.
Ow. Okay. Yep. Caravan, I'm going to get one of those. Do you know how many, or where I can see how many caravans I can have per city?
Up, it's not per city, it's just across the Empire. Up in the left, between your gold and your happiness, the X out of Y is trade routes.
Oh, I only have one out of four. Alright, well that's no good. Mm-hmm. Let me... Oh, and I'm sure they cost an arm and a leg, right?
No.
Well, they cost like three times the amount of gold I currently have, so...
Yeah. Yep.
That would take 10 turns. Return to map. Let me see here. How long does it take to build a caravan from here? It literally takes two turns. Alright, I'm gonna build. So I got one there, one there, one there. Yeah, you can't construct a trade unit because you are at your trade unit limit.
What? That's.
I think because I have other ones that are being constructed.
Hmm.
Alright, return to map. Okay. Pantheon founded. Japan has started worshipping a pantheon of gods. They've chosen to believe goddess of the hunt plus one food from camps. I'm almost to the point where I can buy another missionary or something.
Mm-hmm. I've built a galleass to help with my naval bombardment of Zulu.
I need to do that, but I haven't yet.
Mm-hmm.
I should. I really should. But I'm trying so hard to, like, offset the fact that I have a million and one, like, units and no money. See, once war breaks out and I start losing units, I'll have a whole bunch of money.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the galleass and the trireme, if you have an area with a lot of water and you can get a couple of them in there and hang the trireme back, and then once the city goes down, just drive it right up onto the land and take the city, that's always a good, it's always a good strat.
Yep.
Roman ballistas. Should I make a declaration of friendship with Rome?
That would probably not go over well, because the other AIs would probably notice that you did that and then attacked.
Alright, let me see what the trade routes I have available are. I can go to Prague. I can go to Kumei, which I don't really like.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if I change the home city to... Oh, it just tells me where it goes to. Let me try and do that. Well, see what happens.
If it's a naval one, Tomoak might be able to go to some of Japan's cities.
Well, Tomoak's the only naval or the only ocean city I have.
Yep.
So I'm taking this land caravan and putting it over at Agadika?
Yep.
And... workshop. I'm gonna remove this caravan here, return to map, and I'm gonna build another caravan here, because it only takes two turns to build over here.
Mm-hmm.
So why bother waiting like 10 on the other place? I can just build it in two and then move it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm ready. I'm almost able to buy something with faith. See, I have like whales and stuff up north, but I can't buy anything and get it. I can't get a boat up there, basically.
Yeah.
Okay, caravan. Established trade route. Ooh, okay, so I can get to Japan. That'll give me one science. Four gold. I'm gonna do that. There we go. Starting to work out a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Starting to come back up. Getting the gold. I'm very happy. I'm a very happy city. I just have no money. So, you know, I don't want to say that there's like a lesson to be learned there, but.
Meanwhile, I've got 71 gold a turn and 22 happiness.
Wow. You have plus 71 gold a turn?
I'm the Dutch. It's what we do.
That's insane. I have negative 1 gold a turn. I have no gold whatsoever. My religion is like bringing gold in. Oh, man. So I have 17. I think it's literally just. Oh, what else do I have? I almost have to trade with them. Well, I'm just going to trade with these guys because it gives me more gold.
Mm-hmm.
Frog, yeah. I'll trade with Mogadishu. Okay. So I have, like, 39 income, but I have 36 in total expensive because 21 of it's on unit maintenance alone.
Yeah. Yeah, 133 income, 60 expenses, half of which is units.
I imagine I could, like, get rid of some of these units, like.
Well, they're going to when you send them to their deaths in glorious battle.
But I'm imagining that, like, the Pathfinders aren't even really all that good. Better than not having them, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Declaration of friendship has expired. Losing grasp on Prague. Well, that's Prague's loss, not mine. I think I can buy a missionary. Yep. Okay, I didn't mean to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Why can't I buy it? Can I not buy it? Because it's not my turn. Choose research. What do we want to do? Do you need anything? Do you need banking?
I mean, banking will help eventually. I don't know if I need it next.
So machinery would bring crossbowmen, which doesn't really help all that much. Longswordmen, but they cost more, I think. Requires iron, but I already have it. But that'll bring me into gunpowder, and that's really where I want to be. So I'm going to go with steel.
Mm-hmm.
And then, why can't I buy... I've discovered education. Why can't I buy a missionary here? There it goes. All right, next turn.
When am I going to actually be ready to attack? That's the question.
Never. It's just better to do it and see what happens. Should go to Mogadishu and... Can I give you a gift?
It has to be within my territory.
Gift a unit and I'll earn 5 influence. No, I don't want to do that. I do want to give you... How close do I have to be to a city to spread my religion? I just have to be next to it, right?
I think so.
Okay. I really enjoy that, like, Rome is getting pressure to follow Eupicism.
Mm-hmm.
Next turn. All right, here we go. Shaka Onji. All right, let's go. Japan's probably gonna be upset if I spread religion to them.
Probably.
Oh, I can build a mine over there. That's good. What is this? Mental burnout. Oh, I got a great engineer. What do great engineers do?
You typically want to save them to rush production on a wonder. Your camera died.
Did it?
It's just a black screen.
Oh, you know what? It dropped, so I'm not even going to bother with it.
Yep.
So you want to save them to do a wonder, or do you want to save them for construct a manufactory?
It depends. I typically prefer saving them for a wonder, because, you know, you start building a wonder, then you rush production, and it's done the next turn. Or you can get a steady, constant bonus to production with a manufactory.
All new trained units. Hagia Sophia brings in more faith, which gives you a great profit and provides a free temple in the city it's built.
I'm currently deciding between Alhambra and the Angkor Wat.
I'm just curious if I can...
I'll let you get Alhambra because that's more combat stuff, even though it does boost culture by 20%, and I'll work on the Angkor Wat.
Alhambra is what? The, I don't know if I can build it in... Which city can I build it in?
It's just a wonder, so you should be able to build it technically anywhere.
Machu Picchu, plus 25 gold from city connections. Ooh, maybe I should build Machu Picchu.
Yep, that could be good.
I think I'll do that. Back. Return, and then I'm gonna take you, sir, and I'm gonna move you down here. Alright, yeah, let's see what we need here. Okay. That gives me 6 to Tokyo, but this gives me 6 and pressure. So I'm gonna do that. Next turn. All right, my gold's coming back up. I have plus 8 now, so there's that.
Okay, I think I need another turn to get my trebuchets in position. But then,
this guy
there will
here.
Be hell to pay.
He's... I'm trying to go for the combat victory, and I wouldn't want to fight you right now, who's going for the cultural victory. That does not make me feel good about my playstyle. That's not a good feeling there.
If Austria decided to, you know, stab me in the back, I would just get crushed over there, but...
Oh, what happened?
Genoa wants deep dishism.
A deal? What is all these deals that just, like, broke?
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. There we go. Ah, yeah. 6 followers over there. Choose production. Where am I choosing production at? Oh, here. Okay. Alhambra. Walls, granary. Colosseum, a market would probably be good.
Mm-hmm. This galley ass is more like a slow ass.
Yeah, they're pretty slow, but they're the ranged ones, right?
Yep.
What else do I want here? I got a market. Colosseum. I don't really worry about the happiness too much. Amphitheater. I don't care about that. I want the shrine for sure. The library for sure. And then I think...
Also, looking at Champs' reaction to the latest critical role, it's great.
Oh man, I'm so far behind. Yes. I don't know if I'll ever catch up.
I mean, when I first discovered it, I was on the bench at work and had nothing else to do than watch D&D all day, every day.
Oh, don't get me wrong. When I used to work in the graphics shop, because we have a whole bunch of machines that are in there, that once you start them doing something, you have to monitor them.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to, you know, run my stuff for, like, the week, and then I would have to sit in the office and watch. So I had a whole bunch of YouTube series and channels I used to watch all the time, and now I don't do any of it, it seems like.
Mm-hmm. All right. Watch this. As soon as I do this, he suddenly brings a bajillion units storming down to crush me.
I hope not.
I'm not even gonna publicly denounce him. I'm just gonna declare war.
Declare war.
Leroy Jenkins. And now I suddenly have a lot less gold because he had 3 trade routes going with me.
I really enjoy that it says your city-state allies have declared war on Shaka, which is Mogadishu, which is all the way across the map.
Yep.
Oh, but I think it wraps around, right? So actually, they're not too far away if you think about it in those terms.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. So you just declared war and you're done?
Well, now I have to have everything attack.
Yeah. Nice. Oh, that's almost done. That city's not too bad. Here comes the Gallius.
So slow.
We have 9 people watching us. Hello, everybody.
Stop. You need to shoot their dude.
For anyone watching, I apologize that my camera froze, but for some reason it does not like Civ and it keeps shutting down. So instead of trying to mess with that, I'm just going to leave it off for now. But thank you for coming on out. We really appreciate you stopping by.
And you get to watch my amateur warmongering.
Yeah, it's basically how I do the same. Like, just put everything there and throw it at them and mm-hmm. hope it just goes away.
Yep.
I think Japan's gonna be mad if I send my missionary over there to infiltrate him with religion.
Yep, probably.
Okay, so I'm gonna make Machu Picchu my main thing. Return to map. Hurry production. Choose research because I finished steel and I wanna go for gunpowder. Hey JBS325. Yeah, we're kind of in the middle of just a casual game. The 2 human players on a team basically versus all of the AI. So we're not doing anything too crazy or too difficult, really. So like I said, it's just a casual game. We're just hanging out and mostly talking while we play Civ. So we hope that you guys are enjoying it. If you guys have any suggestions or tips on what we can be doing to be playing better, go ahead and feel free to type them into the chat there, and we'll gladly, you know, take it under advisement, because I'm very bad at this game, apparently. I'm over here struggling to get a dollar together while the teammate over there is going for a cultural victory, has all the money in the world, and is fighting a war, so it's fun.
Yeah.
It's a good confidence boost.
Let's see. University or amphitheater? Amphitheater, because it's fewer turns. Alright, let's... We're gonna get to musketmen before we get crossbowmen.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's what I'm planning on. I'm just gonna step right over the crossbowmen.
Yep.
I would be more concerned about it, but for some reason, I seem to be having this gold problem, so I can't even really afford to upgrade all of my stuff.
Yeah, meanwhile, I'm just buying a couple Landschnecks.
So, yeah. I'm just over here watching you decimate everything.
Yep.
Oh, is Genoa your ally?
Yep.
Oh, so
which is part of why I wanted to attack sooner than later before I was no longer an ally. Let's put you on alert, because then hopefully you'll get a slight bonus in case you get attacked, but I think that's everything. And yeah, Civ multiplayer can be a lot of fun, but it's also... it can be finicky. Oh! Okay, yeah. What just happened? Okay, so...
It's had finicky.
Yeah. No big deal, just some of my dudes getting attacked. Okay. Pikemen attack the knights, because that's what you do.
Alright, Osaka. Feel the love of Yupikism. Join the fold. Become one with us. What is this here? Mental Burnout has completed Machu Picchu. That's pretty good. Machu Picchu is a good thing. What we got going here? Borobudur? I don't know what that is.
That sounds like something from Lord of the Rings.
I'm building it, though.
Let's see. Some of the bugs. So, Robert, who's playing with me, has been kicked out a couple times.
I'm pretty sure that's because of my camera software. For some reason, the software that I use to stream doesn't like Civ, and it's given me a couple issues with a few other games, but mostly it's something to do with Civ running on DirectX and the camera software also trying to access it. They're not lining up quite right. So what ends up happening is my camera software shuts down and it gives me an error code, and then when I go to restart it, it shuts Civ down. So I've just opted to leave my camera off this time. I believe Saber Expert said earlier that there's something that if you alt-tab out of the game, it can freeze the game for other people in the multiplayer lobby, which is kind of weird, too.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, we haven't had too many bugs.
Yep.
Aqueduct. What else do I want? Stoneworks. Monument. I might as well get one of those, I guess, in my capital city eventually.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. And I'm good.
Yep. I took one of their cities, turned it into a puppet.
Nice.
Yep. I think that's it for this turn.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure those are the only bugs that we've really had.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, it's been pretty smooth, I think. I've gotten a couple glitches, but I think that they're because the game shut down and then I rejoined. And when the game shuts down and you get kicked out, your civilization defaults to AI. So they would move all my characters around, and then I'd log back in, and I would try and move them back. And I had a couple graphical glitches where some of my characters that were embarked were on land, and they still looked like they were in boats, but nothing gameplay-wise, really.
Yep. So many notifications. So
Sydney has declared war.
Can't build Machu Picchu. Bogota want Alhambra, but I believe you're working on that. Shoshone are no longer the ally of Mogadishu. Is that because I am? No? Okay, just loss of friendship.
To me it says we're friends still.
But not the ally. Ally is a level above being friends.
Maybe. It might have something to do with me spreading my religion.
Austria's getting a lot of technology. They beat us out against that quest for Sydney.
Really?
Yep, but we also haven't been actually focusing on
research and tech.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not too bad, though. So once you're done, like, decimating over there, you know, maybe you can give me some pointers on how to actually play this game, because apparently... I enjoy how you're like, man, I started in a really bad spot, and you have, like, way more stuff over here than I do.
Well, it's because this had been a desert, and then I got something that let... Oh, it's the Dutch thing, the polder. It just makes super food, so I have 23 citizens in my capital. You can just work like crazy.
That's interesting.
Yep. Dudes are in
I was gonna say, because I'm like up in this tundra area and it's no good. Mm-hmm. Like, there's room for food and stuff, but like, my capital city only has 8 people in it.
Yep. Yeah, no. So, bumping food production is good, because the sooner you get that up and running, the more resources you can get going, and it just helps. So.
Probably change it over to food production. Great people. Wonders. Broke epic buildings. Okay.
This lynch neck's probably about to die. For the glory, for honor! Because I at least get gold for how much damage it does to a city. That's a thing Lanchnecks get.
Alright. Next turn. Mm-hmm. How do you increase the amount of trade routes that you can have? Is it just based on city, or...?
I mean, there are some buildings you can build.
I'm loading right now.
Yep, same. So this is another bug that sometimes happens. And actually, because your camera is gone, I'm just going to go ahead and remove the black box from the stream. And
yeah, that's fine.
Yep, there we go. That's a little bit better.
Yeah, that's perfectly fine. I don't really have much else to build up here. Mm-hmm. I mean, I might as well just go and start putting farms down. Unless I can build a mine here, or maybe like Hagia Sophia was complete by Augustus Caesar.
Well, that's
I'm no
just
longer
great.
Friends with them. Shaka made peace with Mogadishu.
I guess because we're not allies with them anymore, so they're not at war.
Sydney has declared war on Shaka. Alright. Interesting. So let's see, technologies increase trade routes as well as certain buildings. Okay. Alright, I'll have to take a look at that. I'll probably, once this one's done down here, I need to build a harbor in it. I'm trying to get the workshop done, but man. Harbor. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to do... What just happened? Workshop, show queue, and then add to queue. It keeps dropping that too.
Oh, Amsterdam can attack that trireme. That's good to know. Yep. You're gonna Leroy Jenkins this line schnecked.
Next turn. Why are you guys building something that's not even in the territory? Oh, you're building roads.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do that.
Roads are useful.
I can't afford them. They cost so much money.
Well, that's why commerce will be good, because reduced maintenance on them. Purchasing items is now 25% cheaper. That's going to be marvelous. Does that make Lanchnex cheaper? Yes, it does.
That does help, because I think if I build a road to the cities, it connects them to the trade network, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I guess I should probably do that. A spy has been recruited.
Yep. Someone got, because Shaka entered the Renaissance, so now there's espionage, which was, I forget if that was in Gods and Kings or Brave New World, but that's a new thing we can do. You have to decide the merits between spying and counterintelligence.
Well, I think we're one of the higher up levels of technology, so...
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Achieve the rank of recruit. Move.
I just got a great general. That's great.
Although Austria is probably a little bit higher up than us, huh?
Yeah, I mean, it might behoove us to spy on them some.
I don't know what it is about this cat, but it is just like lounging across the top of the router.
Router is heat. Heat is life for cats.
I think it's more about the internet. It's just sucking it up. It's internalizing it.
Well, how do you think all the cats get on the internet in the first place?
Right? They are our secret overlords. Ooh, I've accumulated enough faith to purchase a unit. What unit do I want to purchase? Oh, I want to purchase a missionary here. Yep.
Okay.
Return to map. Yep. Okay. And then I'm going to go on over to Prague here and start spreading some love.
Alright, do I want to do counterintelligence or... No, let's try...
I'm doing counterintelligence. I have my guy sitting on my capital right now. But I was contemplating sending him to Austria because...
Yep, well, I will attempt to put him as a diplomat in Vienna.
Okay.
Because attempt to steal technology, but will still provide intrigue. And then, we're not at ideologies yet, but... So, diplomats are useful.
Okay. I think... Yeah, we've got about... less than 45 minutes until Champs is going to be streaming.
Yep. The Vatican City wants deep dishism.
Deep dishism for the win. I have a feeling that... Alex is just gonna win, and I'm just gonna be here to watch at this point.
Well, we're on a team, so you'll still get the victory.
I'll still win. I'll be there in spirit. Yes. Continue to build the road. Adopt a policy. Okay. +2 gold from your land trade routes. Maintenance paid on roads and railroads reduced by 50%. Yep. Doing it. Close. Next turn. Alright, waiting. Once I start fighting something eventually, I'll have a lot of stuff to do on my turns too.
Mm-hmm.
Is your you have the Great General, but it doesn't actually do anything, right? Or does it
so
give?
So if it's near your units, it gives a bonus.
Okay. Oh, you've got no bomber right now. You just got to get someone in there.
Yep. But I have very few units who are healthy enough to survive.
So you need a trireme for. You could put it right up into the channel there.
Well, let's purchase a trireme. Won't be able to use it until next turn, but...
What you have to do with it, I think, if I remember right, you have to actually make it move into the city instead of attack the city, because it won't attack it.
Interesting. Okay. Let's get a university. Actually, no, I should probably refresh my units. Yeah, I have 8 iron, so let's get a bunch of longswordmen up in here. And this dude chilling over here can get upgraded. Let's put some walls there just in case. Okay. Oh, promote a unit. Alright, trireme. Coastal Raider. Okay. I also have enough faith to buy a thing. Can't get a missionary there yet, but can I get a cathedral? No, because that city doesn't have my religion, nor there. Okay. Oh no, I'm no longer friends with Geneva.
How's it going, Prague? How you doing? Look, Prague, all I'm saying is feel the religion. Now, do roads destroy stuff that it goes through or no?
Nope.
Okay. Alright, that's good to know. Mm-hmm. You still have barbarian encampments over by you?
I guess. I haven't paid much attention to them.
How am I friends with Bogota? They're like way over there.
They probably had a quest that you completed.
I think I might be trading with them.
That could do it too, yep.
Okay. I'm really glad you're the one that's hosting the stream, because your stuff's way more interesting than mine. Mine's usually like, move this worker here and then hit next turn.
Yep. Alright, let's send my new longswordman after that encampment. It's another thing to do.
Where's that at? Oh, after the barbarian encampment. Yep. Yeah.
It was just a bowman. But they are getting new units seemingly out of nowhere.
Rome has founded a new religion.
Catholicism, because they're not creative with their names.
Yeah. Where should I go for... Oh man, my religion's spreading pretty far. kind of want to go to Pagoda with it. Maybe the mercenary will get there. Who knows? We'll see. We'll see if the mercenary gets, or the missionary gets over there.
Yep.
If not, it's fine. Not doing too well anyways. Could upgrade. Yeah, why not? Start upgrading some of these units. I can't upgrade my pathfinders, which I think is really weird. Go down here and watch the war. And in this corner. And they went in there and like burned everything, didn't they?
Yeah, that's what they do to city states.
That's rough.
Mm-hmm.
Trireme's just not having luck.
One of my trebuchets got killed. And where did my trireme also get destroyed?
Yeah, I think so. Oop. All right, we've discovered gunpowder.
Huzzah.
Musket man. Choose research. Astronomy will bring a caravel. I mean, I'll probably just get machinery because...
I can turn my longswordsmen into musket men.
Do it. Chemistry would bring us the cannon.
That would be useful, yep.
But it's 44 turns, I think, if we get some of these other ones.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to start on machinery to finally get crossbowmen. Mm-hmm. You have discovered gunpowder. Next turn. Okay. All right. Bullywayo, Puppet City. How's your happiness?
22.
That's not bad.
Yep, pretty good for being at war.
Yeah. Oh, there he is. There's my little missionary guy. He's a little cute. You go, missionary guy. You make that journey. And that'd be a really interesting spot for a city. Out in the middle of the water.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's stuff around, you know? There's, like, fish and there's production. There's stone out there, but...
Oh. Maria Teresa is constructing Alhambra. I don't know if you're already on it or what.
You can see that they're constructing it?
It's what my spy told me.
Does it say how far? I'm trying to build this Borobudur.
6 turns.
I took castle off. And I see if I can even make it. No, it would take me way too long.
Okay.
I need like 25 turns. I'm a few turns away from this one I'm working on, so I'm hoping I can get that. I What you doing?
Trying to decide whether to attack the city or kill off one of their units.
Tough choice.
Yep. I'll attack the city because I just got a new musket man.
Nice. You're pretty close to capping that.
Yep. But then they still have two more cities.
That's fine.
And the Zulus just founded Buddhism. That's not gonna last very long.
No.
Kill any of my dudes.
City connection established. There we go. That's what I wasn't doing. All of a sudden, my gold jumped up.
Yeah.
As soon as I got that road there. That amateur hour. Alright. Well, that makes sense. Okay. Next turn. What to do?
Well, that Landschneck's probably doomed.
Doomed Landschneck.
And now let's send this musket man after that barbarian encampment. Oh, I got another great merchant.
There's so much iron. It says that none of it's being used. Oh, do musket men not require iron?
I don't think so.
That's interesting.
Okay, hold on. If I put... Yeah, I'm not even gonna get any bonus if I put him there. Well, let's head over to Rotterdam.
Yeah. This is man. I need to do something. Mm-hmm. I feel like I'm stagnant over here. Just gonna go in and start attacking stuff just because.
Yeah, you've been preparing to attack Kumei forever.
Well, it's because I ran up against the wall of having money issues.
Yep.
And I've been focusing on fixing that, and I'm almost to the point where it's like not even a worry anymore, but now my troops are like 110% behind.
Yep.
But I finally got my marketplace up. So, let's see. Temple, gardens. Gallius would be pretty nice. Trireme.
Okay, we had 53 dropped frames at some point throughout this whole thing. Just glancing over at OBS.
It's not too bad, though.
Yep, it's 0.03%.
Yeah. Alright. Oh, you're waiting on me. Okay.
You're fine.
Alright. Yeah.
They killed my Landschnecht. How dare.
How very dare. What is that? Oh, that's crab. How many iron? There's 6 more iron there? I'll just go grab that spot.
No, okay. Bamba, you die.
Oh, Alright, trade caravan. Ooh, I could keep trading with Osaka and get +8 and keep giving them pressure. And they would be pressuring back with my own religion, unless they're using... total would be 7 gold base. Like, if I pick a symbol for my religion, they can't have the same symbol, right?
Correct.
Okay, so they would be giving... I'd be giving their city pressure, and they'd be giving my city pressure back because I infected their city with my religion.
Nice. I have captured Nobamba.
Ooh, but this would be 7, which is only 1 gold less. Yeah, I want to give pressure. Nice. I definitely want to give pressure out. I want to keep that kind of like religion spreading because it seems to be one of the only things I have right now.
Mm-hmm.
That's halfway decent. I have a lot of production, but not a lot of resources and stuff.
Yep.
A lot of stone. Maybe I should just get a settler and settle another city so I have something going on.
Mm-hmm. I can't get... Oh, worker, get out of there. I want to buy a missionary.
Yeah, I'll probably settle a city right there. Settler, 5 turns. Sydney's under attack.
Yep. Not a ton we can do about it right now.
Add to queue, settler. Let me bump this up to 2nd place. Oh, no. There we go. Yeah, you guys build a quarry there. Choose research. Astronomy will give us the observatory, faster embarked movement, and allows embarked units to cross oceans.
Mm-hmm.
Banking and printing press. Or chemistry. I'm gonna go with printing press, I think. Astronomy. I think astronomy is going to be good.
Yeah.
Apparently I'm unhappy all of a sudden.
We have a barbarian swordsman against my musket man.
Okay, apparently my population is too high.
Yeah, that'll happen.
Done. Obama, man, you're wiping them out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, did they? I think they raised all my fishing boats, so I'm gonna get that going again, because that's a nice boost. I am down to 18 happiness a turn.
I'm down to -1 now.
Hmm.
Or no, just 1?
If it's red, it's negative.
Okay, -1. Oh, loading.
Yep.
Alright.
And is this maybe a good time to call it for today?
Yeah. This will probably be the best one. Whenever this next turn starts up, because I think I'll be done with... whatever they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Alright, that's all done.
Still waiting for... It says it's waiting for players.
Yeah. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and save here. Oh, also, because I'm the Dutch, I am Doge. OMG, it's some guy. OMG, such doge. Wow.
Wow. Much wow.
And with that, okay. I think it's time to call this a day.
Yes, very much so.
Yep. For those of you in chat, stick around. In just about 20 minutes, Champs will be continuing her Let's Play Firewatch, which yep. I've been told is very entertaining. I myself am not watching it because I would like to play it at some point myself and want to avoid spoilers. But
yeah, and from what I understand, she's on the cusp of like a part in the story, so it should be pretty good.
And her commentary is great for the bit I did watch.
Her commentary is the best. So yeah, hang out for that. She'll be on in, Alex said, in a few minutes here. You know, and then I'm not sure what else we might have planned later on tonight, but we definitely have Firewatch for at least a little bit. Yep. So we hope to see you guys there, and thanks for stopping out and watching us struggle through Civ. Well, at least watch me struggle through Civ. And, you know, we love everybody. So there you go.
We hope to see you next time we play some Civ. And
yep. Oh, and for those of you that just stumbled across us, if you guys follow us on Twitter at UPickGaming, you'll be able to keep up to date with when we go live, what we're planning on streaming, and what our schedule is. We put all of our updates out on Twitter, so yep. That's the easiest way to keep in touch.
Yep, and of course, follow us on Twitch, and you'll get notified when we go live.
Yep.
But yeah, thanks for stopping everyone. By.
Bye.
Bye.